Hi, my name is Carl Arash. I am a biology teacher and the coordinator of the science program here at Vanier College. Thank you very much for your interest in science at Vanier. We're proud of our program and we thought we'd take this opportunity to tell you a little bit about it. First though, we're going to answer some basic questions about science at Vanier.
Well, across the réseau, all students have to take the same 9 science classes, and there are 3 option classes that they need to take. So, of those 3 option classes, health science students need to take organic chemistry and biology too, which is highly recommended for anyone going into medicine or research in the health sciences.
So the competition is high for the science program. The students accepted over the last few years had overall averages in the 80s, with 80% and over in secondary 5 chemistry, physics, and natural science or technical science mathematics. Please note that if the marks, they vary from one year to the other. So if you are unsure about the prospects of your acceptance, please speak to the admissions directly.
The honors program, let's start with what it isn't. It isn't harder courses. What it is a group that takes all their science courses together, and they are particularly engaged science students. It allows the material to be gone through a little bit faster so that there's a little extra time for activities that are particularly engaging. I think the thing that honor students find they enjoy the most about the program is the sense of community that comes from taking your 3 science courses together in a given semester. So they build a very good rapport not only with their teachers but also with their fellow students.
Well, essentially the computer science and math program is very much like the science program. The optional sciences have been replaced so that the students can take an extra mathematics course and 4 computer classes, 1 each semester. This program was really developed in order to target students that have a preference for either mathematics, computer science, but the general science, technology, engineering, and mathematics programs for further study.
Students interested in science and music can do a science and music double deck and graduate with a diploma in science and in music, allowing them to go to university in both domains. And every semester they take classes from both fields. If they are interested in science and social science, they will graduate with both diplomas and also take courses from both areas in all semesters.
Basically, in terms of science, the fun part in science, and science is fun, of course. So the fun part about English and French is basically the inversion of the words and the change in pronunciation. So if you take the very simple example of table salt, if you talk about chlorure de sodium, and in English it's sodium chloride, well, you've just inverted 2 words that you've heard before, and there you go. So some years ago, we have performed a diagnostic test for our incoming students, and we realized first that there was a lot of students coming from the Francophone sector, and we realized that they are performing as well as the students coming from the Anglophone sector. We do offer a bilingual deck. So this is done with our neighbor college, CÉGEP Saint-Laurent. So what happens during the program is that students would go to CÉGEP Saint-Laurent and take their course in French, and they would be here after that taking course in English, and there will be some alternance between the both CÉGEPs, so that in the end you have covered a bilingual approach to your deck in science.
The college R score is anxiety inducing for a lot of students coming to the college because they know they're going to be marked using it, but they really don't know what it is. So hopefully today, I'll demystify a little bit of that for you. So to understand the R-score, first of all, you have to understand why there's an R-score. Back when the CÉGEPs were founded, they would give you percentage grades, just like in high school. The problem was that, you know, those percentage grades weren't really a great measure of how strong a student you were. They depended a lot on how hard the tests were that you wrote, and that would vary from one class to another. So the R-score is a tool that the universities use to convert those percentage grades into a more meaningful measure of your ability as a student. Okay, so there's 3 numbers that go into calculating your R-score. The first one here is Z. And what Z is it's a measure of how well did you do relative to the course average. So it can be positive if you did better than the course average, or it can be negative if you did worse than the course average. Okay, so there's a pretty obvious reason why we can't just use Z to measure your performance, and that's because of your classmates. So the other two factors here, the IDGZ and the ISGZ, these guys are here to compensate for that effect. So before I explain what they are, I just want to emphasize that this number here, Z, this is the only number that you have direct control of, and you get a good Z score by doing well and getting high marks. The ISGZ measures how well did your CÉGEP classmates do in high school. And the idea that is that if they all did really well in high school, then it's hard to beat the class average, and so everybody should get a little bonus to compensate for the fact that you're in a competitive environment. So if you look here, once your performance has been calculated, they'll add something to it if you're in a smart class. And if you're in a class that performs less well, they'll actually subtract some number. The second factor here, the IDGZ, is a little more difficult to explain. It's a measure of how diverse are the high school marks of the people in your CÉGEP class. Remember, the other one, the ISG, was how good they are. But here it's how diverse they were. And the idea is this. If everybody got about the same mark in high school, then you're all probably about the same level of innate ability. So that's pretty much all the content there is in the R-score. But there is maybe one last thing in the formula that you're interested in and I haven't explained yet. And that's these numbers 5, so plus 5 here and times 5 there. Why are they there and what are they for? Well, basically they're there to make you feel better. If you look at both of these numbers, they can be either positive or negative. And when you add them all up, typical values might lie between maybe minus 3 and 3. So it's not nice to get a negative mark. So, well, they add 5 to it. And so now instead of being between minus 3 and 3, you're between 2 and 8. Okay? 2 and 8 isn't really a big enough range. So what they do is they multiply the whole thing by 5. So now you go somewhere between 10 and 40. So in summary, your R-score is a measure of how well you did here at CÉGEP, plus some bonus for being in a strong class, or some penalty for being in a weak class. The purpose of the whole thing is to take away who your marking scheme was made by, whether the tests were hard, whether the tests were easy, and also then to compensate for being in a strong or a weak class. The end goal that the ministry has when they calculate the R-score is to give you a fair assessment of how you did in your course that the university can understand.
That's our science program. Students really are at the center of everything we do, and we work really hard to provide the best possible learning environment and overall college experience for students who choose Vanier. We really hope that will include you. Trust me, it's a choice that you will not regret. If you have any questions at all, feel free to email science@vanier.college, and hopefully we'll see you around.